Fatherland at a very fundamental level is about the nature of reality, how we experience reality, and how we as human beings try and fill in the gaps between those two things.
Fatherland is a journey of a father and son later on in life when the father gets onset dementia and the son has to come to terms with that. And it's not an easy thing. And he feels he's sort of becoming this carer that's not really a role that he's used to.
The son constructs this theory that his father is not in fact ill.
And he starts to kind of develop these conspiracy theories.
Becomes convinced that these Nahuales, these Mexican witches, are working in collaboration with this giant pharmaceutical company.
And to come to terms with this, he has to bring in a carer, which he doesn't really accept.
And Esperanza, the carer, is the one who has her feet very much solidly on the ground. And the story revolves around the conflict of those three. Limbic Theatre is a devising physical theatre company. With this work, we are now sort of moving into this really exciting new territory of taking our skills at creation and improvisation and devising and applying it to digital technology.
We found a way to bring theatre and technology together to storytell without taking away either medium. They balance.
We've tapped into something that is quite special.
Fatherland uses real-time motion capture, streamed into virtual reality, and allows multiple participants from an audience to come up and immerse themselves in the story.
So we began working with a full optical motion capture system. Motion capture involves placing sensors on your body that can be read by cameras. And those cameras take all of the information they receive from those sensors and transform it into literally anything. For the touring production, we're experimenting and we're really trying to work with these trackers, these Vive trackers, which is a much more simple way of achieving the same end of motion capture, and it requires a lot less setup and a lot less technology, essentially.
As a university, we like to think we are one of the leading players, if you like, in the immersive XR area. We're very pleased and proud of the work that our amazing colleagues here are doing.
We work with motion capture performers all the time, with actors, stuntmen, fight coordinators. But what we didn't know how to do was to use that in a live theatrical environment where we can't just say cut and do another take. One of the things that's a bit unique about Fatherland is we don't use headphones in the VR on the VR headset. We use surround sound speakers, we use a Bluetooth speaker on the front of Ben. So we're using live sound, so it works for the participant in VR and it works for the audience, because we have to keep that balance.
We go to the theatre for a shared experience. So for us, the technology has to augment and bring something to the magic of the theatre, not detract from it. I think technology is evolving and changing the face of theatre in ways we can only just begin to imagine.
Fatherland is very much a theatre show that incorporates a lot of new technology. So suddenly you understand that you're not working only in VR, but you might be working in extended reality, in mixed reality, all these other elements that broaden your vision and then make your piece much more rich. And it's been very smooth for us, actually, very weirdly natural to work with all this technology.
There's always those light bulb moments with any project, and Fatherland has had a lot of those. For me, one of the ones I remember most clearly is the bit where you have the mirror scene. So you have Ben as the performer here, and you have the member of the audience here. And that look of wonder. That's mirroring me. How is that? That's a real moment when the volunteer actually connects much more with the performer. So I said that's quite a special moment. The first time we saw that, we were like, yeah, that's definitely something we need to work on and progress with it. But there's been a lot of those, and I think that's why it's having such a close relationship with the artistic community and with creative industries more broadly that makes us ideally placed to move these collaborations forward.
When this project first came about, we put a call out for artists to come in, and I mean artists like theatre makers, to come into the motion capture suite and experiment and find ways of using technology to enhance storytelling.
By the end of the week, we encapsulated that brief and it worked so quickly, and because of the story and the emotion in it. And we had people that had tears in their eyes at the end of a week, which is a ridiculously short timescale for something like that. So it was just the impact. We knew we were onto something special. And that was when the Creative XR call for the prototype came out, and we knew it would be a perfect fit.
Creative XR and Digital Catapult and Arts Council England were offering support in many, many ways. It's not just financial, it's about understanding that marketplace to experts, you know, project management, all sorts of things.
You know, we went to this first meeting. It was like mind-blowing. I felt like I was in the future or something. I remember calling Ben going like, Ben, this is like, we stepped in like the unknown here, you know?
What was amazing about Creative XR was to have that door just opened to the XR world, both in terms of the different kind of perspectives that were offered throughout the workshops, as well as the opportunity for us to just gain experience in things like pitching.
Being in collision with other creators, you know, and creators, producers, and all that has been quite nourishing the way we've been working with it. Yeah.
So the future of this piece is going out on the road. We're going to take it on a tour. We're in conversations with international festivals.
The fact that we've been able to bring together the Digital Catapult, Arts Council England, and work together collaboratively with Limbic Theatre on this project has been really crucial. It's taken it to the next level, both in quality and in international connections. So it's really helped to move it a step forward and helped on the development of all of us, from Limbic to the University of Portsmouth. And we can't wait for the next round.